Hello, welcome to Computer Science Sub. Our subject Computer Fundamentals, topic KMAP. This is the part 2 video. In this video, we are discussing about the KMAP method of simplifying Boolean functions. So in the before video, part 1 video, we have discussed what is a KMAP, how we can represent variables using KMAP, about 2 variable, 3 variable and 4 variable KMAP. Okay, and here now we are going to use this KMAP for simplifying Boolean expression. And this is a KMAP, this is a 4 variable KMAP, we know that. To understand the usefulness of KMAP for simplifying Boolean expressions, we must recognize the basic property possessed by adjacent squares. That property we already know, right? We know that in KMAP, each adjacent squares differ only by a single bit. Consider this this cell, fifth cell, okay. The adjacent cells are 1, 4, 7 and 13, right? These 4 cells are adjacent to this cell. And if we consider any of the cell, we can find this property that they differ only by a single bit. And that bit which is primed in one square and unprimed in the other. So consider consider the fifth cell and its value is 0101, right? 0101. Consider the 13th cell. Its value will be 1101, which means the first letter, first bit is primed here, then unprimed here. All the other bits are same. And consider the next cell, seventh cell. Seventh cell is 0111. Fifth cell is 0101. Seventh cell is 0111, which means every adjacent cells differ only by a single bit. This is the most important property of KMAP, and this property is used for simplifying Boolean expressions. Next term is about subcube. Subcube means a set of exactly 2 raised to m adjacent cells containing ones or zeros is called a subcube. We know how to represent POS and SOP forms in using KMAP, and for SOP, sum of products we use by marking ones, right? Marking ones in our columns, in all our cells, cells that representing the SOP expressions. And for POS, we mark 0 for the cells, for the corresponding POS expression, right? And that marked adjacent cells are known as subcube, a set of exactly 2 raised to m adjacent cells containing a 0 or 1 is known as subcube. And there are some categories of subcubes. First one, if m is equal to 0, if m is equal to 0, the subcube contains, which means 2 raised to 0. 2 raised to 0 is equal to 1. Means the subcube contains only a single cell. And such subcubes are known as 0 cube. Then when m is equal to 1, m is equal to 1 means 2 raised to 1. That is 2. It contains 2 adjacent cells. And it is called a 2 cube or a pair. We know 2 adjacent cells are known as a pair or a 2 cube. Then when m is equal to 2, it will contain 2 raised to 2, which means 4 adjacent cells. 4 adjacent cells are known as a 4 cube or a quad. Then when m is equal to 3, 2 raised to 3 is equal to 8, right? And such subcubes having 8 adjacent cells are known as 8 cubes or octets. Okay, this is important. So study all these terms. A 0 cube means a single cell and a pair means 2 adjacent cells, right? Like this or like this. Next, a quad means 4 cells together, like this. This is a quad, and this also, these 4 cells also a quad, these 4 cells also a quad. Then 8 adjacent cells are known as octet, which means these 2 areas, this is an octet, and also these 2 is an octet, this top row and second row together is an octet, okay, like that. So this is about the structure. Next, coming on to the simplification using the subcubes. Using the subcube, we can simplify Boolean expression. For that, observe the KMAP from both row-wise and column-wise for each subcube. We have to check for every subcube. And for each subcube, select the variables that are common in all squares in a subcube, both in row-wise and column-wise. Discard uncommon variables in a subcube, both in row-wise and column-wise. This is other method. First, we have to select all the subcubes. Then in a subcube, if the variables are same in both a column and row, then we can retain that variable. If the variables are different, which means one is 0 and other is 1, we can discard that variable. For example, I will show you. And suppose this is our K map, a 4-variable K map, and here the value of A, here the value of B, and we have a 0 and we have 1. Here also we have 0, here a 1, and we have 2 ones here, which means a pair. This is our pair. Okay. And also consider another one is here, and we can make another pair, right? Adjacent ones are known as a pair, right? So this is another pair. Then our method for simplification is just look for all the subcubes. So consider this first subcubes. For this subcube, select the variables that are common. So consider the variables. The values of A. Values of A is, for the first one, value of A is 0. And for second one, value of A is 1. Okay? Which means these values are different, uncommon. We can cancel. Okay, these 0 and 1 got cancelled. Which means A completely got cancelled. No value for A. And for B, both ones come under a single row. Which means A only one bit is there. Same bit, common bit is there. Which means a B is here. Then consider this second subcube. Here, in place of A, we have only a single 0. And in place of B, one is under the column 0 and another one is under the column 1. Which means uncommon variables, we can cut those variables, discard those variables. Only the remaining is 0. A is 0, which means the variable is A bar. This is the method. I will explain it in detail in the coming examples. Consider how to form a pair. So this is our K-map. And suppose these are the distribution of our ones. Then easily we can make two pairs from this. This is one pair. This is another pair. Okay. And next, the values. These pair, I have already explained this, right? And here two ones are there. One is under the column 0, under the row 0, and another one having the value 1, which means this can be discarded. A got discarded and B's value is 1. Which means the entire expression can be represented by a single B. Then consider this. Here A is 1 and B is 0 and 1. B got cancelled. The entire expression can be expressed using a single A. Consider another one. So this is mean terms, right? Ones are the products are here. So this is mean term. And for max term, we use zeros for representing. And here also we can make two pairs. Okay, this is one and this is one. So first pair and second pair. And the values, same case, but here it is max terms. Max terms means for the first group, we have a zero. Zero for max term is A, right? A. If it is mean term, this will be A bar, but it is max term, so it is A. And here this B got cancelled. And the next subcube, A got cancelled because it's 0 and 1 and B is 0, which means value is B itself. This is about pair in 2-variable K-map. Consider 3-variable K-map. Some differences are the, these are the markings. Okay, these are the number of ones. Then how can we make a pair? Easily, this can make a pair. This one is a pair. Then this one also a pair, okay? Then there are two ones left ungrouped, right? They do not come under any group, but we can make this one into, these two ones we can make into a group, to a pair. But this one will be free, or we cannot find any groups for this one. But there is a property of K-map. This K-map can be considered as folded or cylindrical, which means this K-map, imagine as we are folding this K-map. When we are folding, this leftmost end comes adjacent to this rightmost end, right? So these two ones are adjacent. This is an important property. In K-map, K-map is cylindrical or K-map can be folded. So the leftmost end, all the cells in the leftmost cell, leftmost columns are adjacent to all that in the rightmost. Similarly, the topmost. Here, no problem. When we consider the four variable kmap, we can easily identify that property. All that cells in the topmost row is adjacent to all that rows in the bottommost. Okay. So we can see that these two ones are adjacent. These two ones can make a pair. This is a pair. Then what are the values? Consider this. For this pair, A's value is 0, which means it is A bar. And consider for B. For B, I will write the values. For B, the first one comes under 0, 1. And the second one's value is 1, 1. Right, and this is B and this is C, which means B's value are uncommon. We can cancel this B, and C's value is the C. Both C's are 1, which means C's value is retained. Our result will be first one A bar, right? A bar, since it is mean term, we need products. So A bar into, and here B got cancelled, which means C is left. A bar into C. A bar into C is our answer. Consider the next group, this vertical pair. And here, this A got cancelled, right? 0 and 1, so A got cancelled. And for these two ones comes under the same column, which means their values are same. B and C. B and C is 1, 1. So easily, its value is BC. Then, consider the next. These two ones. Here, both comes under the same row. So, A's value is same, A. Then, for BC's values, just write BC. Then, write first one comes under 0, 0. And last one comes under 1, 0. Which means, again, the B got cancelled. And C's value is complemented. So, C is C bar. And A is a single A. So, our value will be A into C bar. Okay. Next. This is our four variable kmap. And how to mark? Consider these are our markings. And how to make a pair? Easily, this is a pair. And these three ones are do not have any adjacent ones, right? But consider the folding property. When we fold it, these two, I will take laser pointer. These two, when we fold, the leftmost cells comes adjacent to the rightmost cell. The topmost cells come adjacent to the bottommost cells, right? So when we fold it, these one will be adjacent to this one. So we can make a pair. Similarly, this one will be adjacent to this one because they comes under the same row, right? Same column, right? So when we fold, just imagine like we are folding scan up. When we fold it top down, then these two ones will be adjacent. So we can make a pair with these two ones. So I have made all that pairs. Then next step is to write the variable values. So for the first one group, then they all come under the same row, which means A bar B. And here the values of CD, just write the values of CD and we can cancel them. CD, the value is 1, 1 and another value is 1, 0, which means our D got cancelled, right? D got cancelled, C is the. So here we have A bar B and here we have AC. A bar B into C is the answer. Sorry, wrong animation. A bar B into C. This is the answer. Then for this pair. This pair, these two ones. Here, both are coming under the same column. Which means this value is C bar and D, right? C bar D is the. That's we already written here. C bar D. And for AB. AB, first. This is for AB. First one's value is 0, 0 and the last one's value is 1, 0, which means our A got cancelled and 0 is there. 0 means B bar is there. So our value is B bar, C bar, D. Then the leftmost and rightmost one, they all come under the same row. So value for A and B is A bar into B. Here it is 0, 1. So A bar B. Then for the value of C, D, and their value is 0, 0 and 1, 0. Which means C got cancelled. D is there and it is prime. Because it's 0, we have D bar. So A bar B into D bar. This is how we can group the pairs. Next, coming on to quad. How to mark quad? And quad means four ones. So in two variable K-map, if all ones are marked, it's a quad. We can make it as a group and it's equal to. If all the ones are marked, then it is equal to a single one. Because these two, 0 and 1 got cancelled and these 0 and 1 got cancelled, right? Which means its value is a 1. If we are using max terms, then all values will be 0. So our value will be a 0. Okay. Next, consider three variable K map. And these are the mappings. And these are the markings. Then easily we can make a quad here, right? These four ones comes under a quad. Okay, then its value will be, A got cancelled. And for, let's cancel the variables by looking onto this bit, this variables, this expressions. So here, first column has 1, 1 and second column is 1, 0. Second value, first value is same, both are 1. Second value is different, so second value got cancelled. Second value got cancelled means C got cancelled and the B remains. So our entire expression will be here A got cancelled and here also C got cancelled, only AB. This four ones represent a single, four ones represent a single B. Then consider these two ones. Okay. These two ones we can make a pair, right? But we need a quad. So every time we need to look for the maximum subcube. First we have to look for a quad octet. If there is an octet, mark it. If there is not, then look for a quad. If there is a quad, you should mark it. Or it is not, then look for a pair. That is the method. Okay. So here we can easily make a pair, but check whether there is any chance for quad. So no chance at all, right? But when we think about the folding property, these two ones will be adjacent to these two ones. So we can make easily a quad. This is that quad. And the values of that quad, 0 and 1 got cancelled. And the variables here, BC, 0, 0 and 1, 0. Which means C is 0 and B is different. B got cancelled and C is 0. 0 means C bar. A got cancelled. The value is C bar. This is the representation. Then coming on to the four variable K-map. There are more chances for quads. So these are, consider our markings. And easily this is a quad, right? And the value. And next, look, these four ones. This can make a quad. And before, its value is 0 here, 0, 0 and 0, 1. Which means the 0 and 1 got cancelled. Here there is A is 0. A is 0 means we have A bar. There is a mistake. Okay. A bar. Then in the column 0, 0 and 0, 1 means 0 and 1 got cancelled. C remains. C is C bar. So A bar, C bar is our answer. Okay, then I will, A bar C bar is our answer. Okay, next, this four ones can come under a quad. Okay, wrong animation. Just look this four ones. This comes under a quad. Okay. Then what to do here? All that ones are under a single row. Single row means 1, 0. A B bar. The value is A B bar. And since all that columns are coming under a single group, which means all that variables will get cancelled. Okay, this CD path is completely discarded. Only AB path is there. AB path means A, B bar here. When we group all these variables column wise, then AB part will completely got discarded and B, only CD part remains. Okay. So the value will be like AB bar. Then the next ones, here a single one, right? Here a single one is the, so we have to group this one. Then for that, what to do? We have to use that folding property, right? Of course, we can use that folding property. And when we fold, we can make a pair. These two ones comes under a pair, but look for the chance to make a quad. And then, just study this. When the all the corners, all the four corners, 1, 2, 3, 4, are marked, we can make a quad with that corners. And when we fold it, these two ones are adjacent and these two ones are adjacent. And when we fold again, these two ones are adjacent, these two ones are adjacent. Okay, just study like this. When all the four corners have ones, then we can make a quad. This is that quad. These two ones and these two ones can make a quad with that one. Then they are coming under different rows and columns. The first variable is 0, 0, and here it is 1, 0, which means 0 is same, 0, 1. A got cancelled, B is third. B, not B, B is 0, so B dash. And for these two columns, 0, 0 and 1, 0, which means C got cancelled and D bar is third. Our value is B bar and D bar. Okay, this is how we can make a quad. We have discussed almost all the possibilities of making a quad. Next, for octet. Octet means octet is not possible for two variable because there are only four variable. Okay, so octet is possible from three variable and four variable K-map. And in three variable K-map, when all the values are marked, we can make an octet and we can make a single group, and of course it is equal to a one. For max term, if it is 0, then we can make a quad. Sorry, we can make an octet and all that equal to 0. And this is the only method to form an octet in case of 3 variable. Then 4 variable, there are different methods for making a quad. Making an octet. So consider this. Easily, these 8 ones comes under an octet. We can make a group. Then there is 4 ones. We can make quad easily, but look for the maximum subcube. When use the folding property, these 4 ones comes adjacent to these 4 ones because the top row and the bottom row are adjacent. So we can easily make an octet with these 4 ones and these 4 ones. So before that, the value of this octet. Value of this octet is, and B is got cancelled and here A bar is remaining. And here, since we have grouped all that columns, all that value got cancelled, which means we get only in A bar. And here, next subgrouping is, next octet is this. And here, A 0, 0 and 1, 0, which means A got cancelled, B is remaining. B is 0, which means B bar. Then all that columns got cancelled. So our value is B bar for this octet. Next example. Using max terms. We have used max terms. And here, there is no octet is visible, right? But using the folding property, we can easily find, because these 4 zeros comes adjacent to these 4 0 when using the folding property. And like that, these 4 zeros are adjacent to these 4 zeros. So we can make 2 octets from this. And this is that method. This is 1 octet. These 2 are 1 octet and these 2 are another octet. And their values. Here, all that columns got cancelled. And here is a 0, 0 and here it is a 1, 0, which means C got cancelled. C, 0 and 1, and D is remaining. D's value is 0, which means the value is d bar. And for the next, here it is 1, 0, and here it is 0, 0, which means 1 and 0 get cancelled. A got cancelled, B remaining, B's value is 0, which is it is B bar. And all that columns got cancelled. So only value is B bar. This is how to mark an octet. Okay. Next, important points to consider while forming subcubes. First, express the given Boolean function in canonical SOP or POIS form. If you want to reduce that expression using KMAP, first step is to, you should express those using canonical SOP and POIS form. Represent the canonical form of the Boolean function in the KMAP by marking a 1 in all the squares corresponding to mean term that produce 1 for the function, and the remaining squares are left empty or for clarity. Okay, so here we mark for mean terms, we mark a 1 in all that columns, and the remaining columns are, remaining cells are left empty. And opposite for max terms, right? For max terms, for it is POS, for max terms, we mark a 0 in all that columns, and remaining columns are left empty. Every square containing 1s, all zeros in the case of max terms, must be considered at least once. Okay, the next step is, when we marked all that 1s, then next step is to group them. So everyone must be considered at least once. At least once we have to consider that one. Every once. Then first, a square containing a 1 can be included in as many subcubes. This is known as overlapping subcubes. A single 1 can be included. Single 1 or a single 0 can be included in as many subcubes. There is no restriction in that. And it is known as overlapping subcubes. Okay. Then a subcube must be as large as possible. I have already told you that a subcube must be as large as possible. Such as, such cubes are known as maximal subcubes. And the term corresponding to the maximal subcubes are referred to as prime implicant. The maximal subcubes, subcubes must be as large as possible. And that groups are known as maximal subgroups. And the terms representing that maximal subgroups like A bar, B bar, they are known as prime implicant. So when we ask a question like what is a prime implicant in KMAP, means the terms representing, terms corresponding to maximal subcubes are known as prime implicants. Next, a square containing a 1 should not be left alone to be included in the final expression if there is a possibility of its inclusion in a pair. Okay, if there is any possibility of including a 1 in any of the subcube, we have to use that. Do not leave any values alone. Similarly, if there is no chance, we can leave them alone. Okay, if there is any chance, we have to make them, we have to include them in any of the group. Similarly, a pair should not be made if the squares can be included in a quad and so on. That we already discussed, because we have to make maximum subcube. Okay, so first look for octets, then look for quad. Then if there is no quad, then only comes to a pair. Okay. A pair should not be made if these squares can be included in a quad. The map is considered to be folded or cylindrical, that we know, right? The squares at the end of the column or row are treated adjacent squares. This is known as rolling of K-map. This folded or cylindrical property, due to this folded or cylindrical property, the squares at the end of the column or row are adjacent, and this property is known as rolling of K-map. Discard the redundant subcubes. Redundant subcube means is one whose ones are already used by other groups. Okay. If there is, I will explain. Suppose there is a K map and this one is a smaller K map. Suppose this is our map and I have 1, 1, 1, 1. I can easily make a quad, right? Then if I mark a pair with this 2 ones, then this is known as a redundant subcube, because these 2 ones are already included. If all that values are already included in another subcube, then this is a redundant subcube. Here all these 2 ones are already included in a quad, and I am making a pair with this 2 ones, then that pair is a redundant subcube. Okay. The simplified logical expression obtained from the KMAP is not unique. And remember that there are different methods for this grouping. So the simplified expressions from the KMAP may not be unique. Grouping of squares can be made in different ways, which results in more than one logic expression. The grouping should be aimed to obtain a minimal Boolean expression. Okay, our aim is to obtain the minimal Boolean expression. When all the ones representing each term in the original Boolean expression is grouped, the mapped expression is ready for simplification. Okay. The following rules apply. Each group creates a product of sum or a sum of products. The final simplified expression is formed by ORing the product of all the group. Okay. So these are the important points. We have to understand. You should understand all the consider. So our question is AB plus A bar B plus AB bar. And let's check how to mark it. And here there are two variables A and B. And so we can draw a two variable K map. And in that two variable K map, this is an SOP, right? Sum of product expression. For marking SOP, we use number 1. To mark SOP, the columns are cells are marked using the number 1. So here first term is AB. AB means what? 1, 1. So in the cell 1, 1. 1, 1 means one row and one column. So in the cell 1, 1, we have to mark. The 1 is marked. Okay. The next cell is A bar B. A bar B means what? 0, 1. So the column 0, 1. We can mark a 1. Correct. Next is AB bar. AB bar means 1, 0, 1, 0. So mark a 1 here. So all the expressions are marked. Okay. Next step is to simplify. For that, we have to mark the subcubes. Group the elements into subcubes. Since only 3 elements are here, we cannot make a quad. So we go for a pair. We can make 2 pairs, one is this and one is this. So mark that. And we can write the expressions for this vertical pair. A got cancelled and the B value of B is 1. So it represents a B. Then this horizontal square, B got cancelled and the A's value is 1. So it represents A. So we have 2 terms A and B. Since our expression is sum of product, we can make this into sum of products, which means our product is A and B, then use OR gate, A plus B. So this expression is reduced to this. Next question, f of AB is equal to A bar plus B into A bar plus B bar into A plus B bar, which means it's a POS, product of sum expression, and 2 variables are the, then draw a K map. And here, first value is A bar plus B. Since it is max terms, A bar stands for 1. So this term is 1, 0. So mark a 1 over here, 1, 0. 1, not 1. Since it is max terms, we use 0 to represent. 1, 0. Next is 1, 1. So at this column, mark a 0. Next is 0, 1. 0, 1. This column, we mark a 0. So these are the values. Next step is to group them. Again, we can make 2 pairs and write their values. For this horizontal pair, B got cancelled and only A is remaining. And since A values of A is 1 and it is a max term, we can write it as A bar. And this vertical pair, A got cancelled and B is 1. B is 1 means we can write it as B bar. A bar B bar, and write it as the product of sum. So these are our sums, then make it as a product, which means A bar into B bar. This is the representation. Next question, consider a little bit complex expression A bar B C bar plus A bar B C plus A B bar C plus A B bar C bar. This is our expression. Since it contains 3 variables, we can draw a 3 variable K map. This is our K map, and let's mark all these values. A bar B C bar means 0, 1, 0. and locate the column cell 010. This is the column 010. Mark a 1. Next 011, which means 011. Mark a 1. Next 101. Mark. This is the column, right? Mark a 1. Then 100. Mark a 1. So all the variables are marked. Then we can group them. Then check for quads. There is no quad, right? So next step is to check the overlapping. The folding of the map. But when we fold the map, we cannot identify any quad here. So now we can go for a pair. Here one pair and here one pair. Mark that. And this stands for, this under the row, a single row. So A's value is A. And here for B, 0, 0 and 0, 1. Which means 0 and 1 got cancelled. C got cancelled and B bar is there. B bar. So our value is A, B bar. Then consider the next pair. Here A's value is 0, A bar. And C got cancelled. B's value is B. Means A bar B. Then express it as sum of product is equal to A B bar plus A bar B. This is the answer. Next, F of ABC is equal to sigma m 0 to 4567. This is another method of representing the midterms, and the sigma m means we are going to simplify the mean terms, and these are the cell values. We can directly mark those cell values. For that, first draw three variable K-map, and for 0, this is the column 0, mark a 1 here. Then 2, 0, 1, 2, this is 2, so mark it 1 here. Then 4, 100, mark here. 5, 101, mark here. 6, 110, mark here. Then 7, mark here. So all the midterms are marked. The next step is to group. Then easily we can identify a quad over here. And draw this quad. Mark this quad. So one group. We got already one group. And two ones are pending. And using folding method, we can make a pair, right? With these two ones. But that's not the correct method. Always look for maximum subgroup. Maximum subcube. So when we consider these two ones and these two ones, we can make a quad with these two ones, right? Then go for it. Okay. Before that, let's write the variable corresponding to this quad. Here all that ones comes under a single row, that is A. And since all these columns are coming under the group, we can all the values of B and C got cancelled, which means the value for this quad is a 1. Sorry, but that is an A. Next, I mark this subgroup and this another quad. Then the value of, value of this quad is, already told you, this is A. Then consider the next folded quad. Here, value is, A got cancelled, right? And in case of BC, 0, 0 and 1, 0, which means B is 0 and here it is 1. So B got cancelled and C, in place of C, it is C bar. So our answer is C bar. So we have two values A and C bar, and use OR gate to find our final expression. A plus, not C, it's A plus C bar. Okay. Next example. F of ABCD is equal to sigma m of 0, 1, 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 12, 13, 14. Which means here 4 variables are used. So we need a 4 variable K-map. First row, a 4 variable K-map. Then we can mark all these mean terms. Since we use sigma m, we know that we are using mean terms. Then if we write the numbers of each cell at the top bottom corner, or bottom right corner of the cells, we can easily mark all these values. Okay. For me, I can, by our experience or by your experience, we can easily identify which cell is this, which cell is 6, which cell is 6, 8. We can easily identify. For beginners, you can write the column numbers or cell numbers over here, then easily mark this values without any error. So first one is 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, right? We can mark a 1 over here. The next one is 1, so this is the 1 column. Next is 2, so this is the 2 cell. Then next is 4, 1, 0, 0, here it 4. Then here 5, then here 6. Next, our number is 8, right? 8 is this, 1, 0, 0, 8. Next, 9. Then 12, 10, 11, 10, 11, 12. Here our 12, then 13, 14. So all the midterms are marked. Then next step is to group. Easily we can identify a quad, right? Sorry, an octet here. Easily we can identify an octet here. So first step is to mark that octet and its value. All these columns got cancelled and here we have 0, 0 and 0, 1. That 0 and 1 got cancelled, which means D got cancelled. And in place of C, we have 0, which means the value is C bar. Next, so first I'm going to mark all that, group all that values. Next, here 3 ones are here. If we have a 1 over this cell, we can easily mark a octant, right? But now it's not possible. So octet is not possible. Then think for a quad. To get a quad, since here 3 elements are here and here also 3 ones are here, so we can find 2 quads. These, using the folding methods, these ones are, 2 ones are adjacent to these 2 ones, so we can make a quad. And again these 2 ones and these 2 ones, we can make another quad. So first quad, we have made first quad, and here one is pending. This one is not coming into any group. So every, all the values, all the ones should be there in any of the subcube. So we have to mark some subgroups to include this one. For that we again forming another quad, right? These 2 ones and these 2 ones, another quad. So the our grouping is complete. And consider this case, this one, the single one is coming under 3 subcubes, right? 1 octet and 2 quads. And that is possible. That is allowed. Next, we can write the variable values. So considering the octet, its value is, we have already discussed, its value is C bar, right? C bar. Then consider the next quad, this quad. And here the value 0, 1 and 1, 1, which means 0, 1 got cancelled and 1 is there for B. So its value is B. Then here 0, 0 and 1, 0, 0 and 1 got cancelled, which means B bar. So our value is B, D bar. Then considering the next quad, the 0 and 1 got cancelled. Here it is A bar is pending, A bar. And here 0, 0 and 1, 0, again D bar, right? A bar, D bar is our answer. Next step is to, this is SOP, sum of products. So next step is to OR all these terms. C bar plus A bar D bar plus B D bar. This is our answer. Next question. F of ABCD is equal to pi m of 0, 1, 2, 3, these numbers. Pi m means we need product of sum, POS or max term. We need max terms. So use 0 to represent all these terms. First one is 0. So write a 0 in this column. Next one is 1. Write a 0 in this column. Next is 2 here. Next is 3 here. Next is 6. 0, 1, 1, 0 here. Next is 7 here. Next is 8 here. Next 10. 1, 0. 10 here. 1, 0, 1, 0. 11. 1, 0, 1, 1. 14. 14, 15. All the terms are marked. So easily we can identify an octet here. Mark that octet. Okay. I have marked this quad first. Then I have marked this octet. Next, a 0 is pending, right? How to include the 0 in any of the subcubes? So we know that using the folding property, if both if all the four corners are having a number, they can be grouped into a quad. I have already told you that. Here we can see at this corner a zero, and this corner also have a zero, here also a zero, here also a zero. Using the folding properties, all these four zeros can be adjacent. So mark these four zeros into a quad. So our grouping is complete. Next step is to write the variable names. For that, for this octet, all these columns got cancelled. A and B got cancelled. For C and D, values D got cancelled, and the value of C is just C. Value of C is C bar, because we are using max terms, and this one stands for C bar. Next, consider this quad. For this quad, comes under a single row, so values are, since we are using max terms, our variable is 0 0, hence the expression will be AB, A not AB, A plus B, right? A plus B. Then all those columns got cancelled, because all that columns comes under a single group. So a value will be A plus B. Next, consider this quad, the four zeros at the corners. And considering these two zeros, considering the rows. So 0, 0 and 1, 0. Which means 0 and 1 got cancelled. A got cancelled and B is there. And value is 0, and for max term 0 for B. Next, considering the columns 0, 0 and 1, 0, which means 0 and 1. C got cancelled, remaining is D, 0 for D. So we have B plus D, right? B plus D. We can write the final expression as the product of these sums. F of ABCD is equal to A plus B into B plus D into, it's not C, it's C bar, right? This is. Is there any mistake? These one got cancelled. No. This is C bar. Okay. Now, so far we have discussed all the tree variable K-map reduction techniques. Next, considering a question like this, minimize the expression using K-map and realize the simplified expression using AND or gates. Okay. AND or NOT gate. We can use any gates. Okay. Using logic gates. So ABCD equal to pi m of this, which means we need max terms, right? So POS expressions we need. And this is our K-map. And since we have four variable, this is our four variable K-map. Next step is to mark this variable. First mark 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. Then 4. We are using zeros because we need max terms. Then 6, 0, 1, 1, 0. We need 4 first. Then we need a 6. Then we need a 9. Then we need a 10. Then we need a 11. 1011. We need a 14. Here is 14. We need a 15. This is the values. The next step is to group them, right? First, look for any octets. We cannot find any 8 values adjacent, right? Then go for a quad. Easily, here is a quad. This is one quad. Then look, there are four zeros are pending, and we cannot make a quad, because when all the zeros are at that corner values, corner cells, we can make a quad. So that is not possible. The next is to make a pair. Then look for the possibilities for a pair. These two zeros, using folding property, these two zeros are adjacent. Similarly, these two zeros are adjacent. Using folding property, we can mark them. One pair and another pair. Then mark all the variable names. And considering this quad, these 1 and 0 got cancelled, and remaining is A. And value is 1, which means A bar. A bar. Here also D got cancelled, balance is C bar. Since it is POS, our value will be A bar plus C bar. Then considering the next pair, A B bar, then the column 00 and 10, which means D is pending. A plus B bar plus D. This pair for this 10 and 00, which means A got cancelled and we have B. B plus C plus D bar. These are our max term. Then express them in product of sum notation. A plus B bar plus D into B plus C plus D bar into A bar plus C bar. Okay. Now, so we have reduced or minimized the expression using K-map. Next step is to realize the simplified expression using logic gates. Okay. So, this is our expression and the implement is using logic gates. First, we have four variables, right? Then, first step is to write all that. And in this expression, we need B bar. Here, we need A bar. Here, C bar. Here, D bar. Which means, all the four variables should be complemented. So we have to use a NOT gate. This is the first step. A, B, C, D. All the four variables are marked. All the connections are made. And all the connections were made to a NOT gate. So here we can make A bar, B bar, G, C bar and D bar. Next step is to form this term. For that, A plus B bar plus D. We need A, not A bar. We need A. Then we need the outputs, B bar. Then we need a D. And we have to find the sum of these three variables. For sum, we use OR gate. This makes the result. A. Written A, taken A. Then B bar. From this, we can get a B bar. Then taken B bar. Then D. Taken a D. And all them fed into an OR gate. The result will be A plus B bar plus D. That's fine. Next, A bar plus C bar. Next term. So, A bar plus C bar. These two terms need to be ORed. This is how it is done. So, from C bar, I have drawn a line and this is an open connection, which means these two lines have no interconnection. That's the meaning of this curved line. Okay. Is an open connection, then C bar is coming and A bar is coming and both of them are fed into an OR gate and we got A bar plus C bar. Next term is B plus C plus D bar. From here B, from here C and from this D bar. I've drawn all the lines from B, from C and from D bar, then B plus C plus D bar. Then we got the three terms, A plus A bar plus C bar, A plus B bar plus D, B plus C plus D bar. The next step is to find their multiplied form. Multiplication means find their AND. All these inputs are given into an AND gate. And this is our final expression F. This is how we can implement a Boolean expression using logic gates. Okay. So we have discussed how to simplify the Boolean expressions using K-map, two variable, three variable, the four variable K-map, the rules, how to make an octet, quad, then pair, etc. Then how to implement the Boolean expression using logic gates. Hope the concept is clear. Thank you.